Okay, so it's time that time of year again to skirt the cabin. In the summertime, you want this all open so it can aerate underneath the cabin, and the cool breeze can blow underneath the cabin and help keep the cabin cool. But in the wintertime, you want to stop the main airflow underneath the cabin and help trap the heat indoors. And by doing that, we skirt our cabin. We use styrofoam blocking, and because we get the styrofoam blocks for free, and we put the styrofoam blocks in, and then we stapled the plastic sheeting right here underneath the ledge. We stapled the plastic sheeting in, draped it down and over the styrofoam blocks and across the ground, and then I have these big heavy rubber pads that we got last summer. And this one just happens to be 20 feet long, plus or minus a couple inches, and that works out great. It works to A, hold the plastic down, and to work as the windbreak, and B, any snow or rain that falls off the roof there will land on that, and instead of digging away the dirt, it will just hit that, and that'll act as the break, and then it can melt and flow off instead of washing away the foundation. In the summertime, we will leave the rubber mat. We will remove the styrofoam and the plastic, but leave the rubber mat. And next summer, we will put a gutter on this side from front to back, and we'll have it go and drain into probably a water container back here. Not that we actually need one, but we might do it. Just so that, I don't know, just for the fun of it. Maybe do it for a hot water system or something, who knows? But this is the east side, and we'll come around over here. This is the west side. Now the west side is much lower to the ground because the property slopes from east to west. Actually, it slopes from southwest to northeast. Yeah. So the southwest of the property is the high end, and the northeast is the low end. And so this is the high end of the property. So this end is only right here in this corner is only about 2 inches off the ground, and back there is only about eight or 9 inches, maybe 10 inches tops, somewhere around there. I think it's about 10 inches off the ground in that corner over there. So what we had here is we had these concrete pipe sections. Don't know what they're for. Actually, they're not. I don't think they're concrete. They're either concrete or clay. I think they're clay pipe sections, and something like that. But anyway, we got a bunch of those, and we lined those up along the house between the foundation blocks, as you can see. And we got stapled the plastic on the same way as the other side. What we did on both sides where the foundation blocks overhang, we put a flat piece of styrofoam on top of the foundation block so that it doesn't cut the plastic up. And this piece of rubber strip, I do have to break out my sawzall and cut this off because this one is actually longer than 20 feet. Our cabin is 12 by 20 for those who are gonna ask. And again, on this side in the summertime, we will remove the plastic but leave the rubber. And we will be leaving those pipe pieces. We'll leave those all year round. Those have been up there all summer long, all last winter, all this summer, and all, it'll be up all this winter, and we're just gonna leave them there. Because not only do they act as a barrier for the wind, as a windbreak and everything, but they also act as a water break too, because all the rain stuff coming from up there washes down this way and goes in, and this does help to redirect water down and away from the cabin some. Next summer, I intend to get one of those, some kind of plastic sheeting or something that you shove down in the ground like this, and coming off about probably 2 or 3 feet away from the cabin, we're going to shove it in the ground. 2 or 3 feet from in front of the cabin, to 2 to 3 feet away. So probably gonna go 3 feet out from the corner here and then 3 feet out from the wall and then shove a plastic sheet down in the ground, about 2 feet into the ground, straight down, and have it stick up out of the ground about 4 inches. And what that will do is any runoff coming down towards the cabin will be redirected away from the cabin. And we'll do the same thing once we have the deck. We'll do the same thing right across the front of the cabin too, right up at the edge of the deck. So there won't be any tripping hazard or anything because the deck will come out, and then right in front of the deck, at the end of the deck, we'll have the same sheeting going across. And then any water coming down will be redirected away from the cabin on these two sides. Now this front here, we will not screen in this front here. One, it's only a few inches off the ground. Two, our cats like to get in and out from underneath. And three, you have to have some kind of ventilation underneath the cabin. And there's our kitten. Echo, and she's like, no.
I'm not. Him.
That's the boy?
Yeah, that's Echo.
That's Echo. Coming up on my leg now. Yeah. So they like to go underneath the cabin. They like to go underneath right there. And they like to go underneath right there. And so
they play back and forth.
That'll give them a place to play where there's no snow or anything. Also, it'll allow ventilation underneath the cabin. And it will allow airflow. You know, it'll allow airflow so that it doesn't get muggy or anything down there. So we'll have the rear of the cabin will be blocked off as well. We have the fiber boards that go across there, and we're gonna go dress that up prettier. We got a mow back here, cut the grass down, and we will reaffix the fiber boards that we have back here so that they are nicer and do the job. Right now, we never took them down from last winter because there was really no need to. And we wanted to keep the chickens out from under there so that they didn't come in the yard now that the fence is up. This year, we're going to, here in a few minutes, we're going to go out and we're going to mow this down. And then we're probably going to screw some of the panels on the ends and then leave the center panel so that we can remove it and actually crawl under the house if we need to. So. But there you go. That's what we're doing today. It's Sunday, October 4th, and we've had to use the stove, the wood stove inside the house for the last two nights because it's getting cold outside. So that means it's time to skirt the house and we want to get it done before the snow comes. We also caulked around the fireplace chimney. Now, we wanted to use the clear caulk and caulk all these seams, but we got the only caulk that we could find in the store was the white caulk, so we got the white caulk. We will get the brown paint and we'll go over it with brown paint at some point in time. Not really that big of a deal, but we caulked all the seams so that there's no leaks or anything. And yeah, to kind of go over that once every couple of years. It was 2 years ago when we caulked it last time when we used clear caulk. And in about 2 years, we'll have to caulk it again. We'll peel off all the old caulk and we'll put on new caulk in 2 years, and perhaps we'll get lucky and find the clear caulk next time. But it doesn't really matter. If you don't like the white caulk, well, it's not your house. It's Addie and my house. And we don't care if it's white or not, so.
Well, we wanted something that was quick drying because it was kind of muggy out.
Also, it was raining and stuff and we needed to get the job done. And
the clear stuff
needed a good 12 hours to dry anyway. And this stuff was rain ready in 30 minutes. So we caulked all the seams and everything so we wouldn't have to worry about any leaks and stuff, so. Because we don't worry about rain. We work whether rain, snow, sleet, or hell. We still have to work to get done. Unlike some people, we can't just sit around all day and expect somebody else to do it for us. So, alrighty. Messed up. Oh, we forgot one of our magnets. There we go. Alrighty. Winter prep. I got to, we did hold off for the clear cock. We got to put some window protector around here for the winter. So last year we used, there's still some staples in from last year, but last year we stapled up a clear plastic on there, and then the clear plastic went foggy on us over time as the sun and whatnot affected it, and it was hard to see out. So I'm looking at doing something different this year. I don't know what, but we'll probably end up with clear plastic on it again.
If but, we wanted to spend a bunch of money, we could just caulk a piece of plastic or the clear plastic plexiglass stuff.
Yeah.
On it.
If we get the money in time, we'll get a sheet of plexiglass and put
just
that up there.
Caulk it on there and then peel the caulk.
Yeah. So, but that would be nice to have. Get the clear caulk, put a bead of clear caulk, a big thick bead of clear caulk all the way around it, and then slap a plexiglass on the window. And then that would insulate the window. The back windows up here on the back wall, those windows up there, I will swing the, not right now, not today, but once winter officially hits and the snow is on the ground, then we'll swing the ladder around over there and we'll put plastic on those windows. That all we need from those windows is light to come in, so that's not an issue. But it is nice to be able to see out the downstairs windows. And this window up here is a well-insulated window, so we don't have to put plastic on that window or anything, because that's a good top-quality window there. And the windows and the doors are good top-quality windows. The windows on the sides, those are just cheap windows, which eventually, one day, we will get these windows replaced with better quality, top quality windows, and we won't have to worry about insulating them in the wintertime. So, okay, winter prep now before it's too late.